I'm all over the place, as usual. Oh, I'm trying. My camera's doing weird shit. Let me get my pellets somewhere because they are in my way. Why are they in my way? Go away. It's haunted. I'm telling you, it's haunted. Well, hello my beauties and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 43 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. Today, I thought, you know, I have been doing so many first impressions with eyeshadows lately. Let me kind of play. I have here my chocolate palettes and I have, well, my avocado and my popcorn palette. Let me kind of show you which ones I have then. Let me go in order of when they came out, or at least when I bought them. But I want my chocolate bar palettes. So I'm starting with the chocolate palettes. So these two that I have here are actually from one of the kits. It was a holiday kit from Revolution last year. You got three palettes. You got two eyeshadow palettes, a face palette, and then one of those heart bronzers. You know, I still have everything. The quality was really good. They have another one this year. So yeah, but you can buy all the palettes that I'm going to use today separately as well. So I have here the red velvet and the peanut butter cup. So let me show you the red velvet. I remember being very, very pissed off about this palette because there is not a red in here. The shade red velvet is not really a red. It's pretty, but it's not really a red in my eyes at least. But it is pretty nonetheless. But anyway, I'm going to use the red velvet. I'm so nasty. I have a little bit of a headache today, so I don't know how the rest of the video will go. I have here the peanut butter cup, which is actually really, really nice. And out of the two eyeshadow palettes, this one was my favorite. And this is the color story. So it's a bit more neutral. You have a bit more browns here, but you also have the browns that are in here are all kind of a little bit off, actually. They're some are on the cooler side. I don't know. The browns that are in here are very, very pretty. Actually, one of the shades that I really love is called Cinder. I'm going to swatch it, guys, because it's so pretty. So again, if you like neutrals, this is a very nice palette. And if you like oranges, this is a very nice palette as well. I don't know why I'm rambling like this, but those two are older palettes and you may not even be familiar with them. Now we go to the newer ones. I have here the slime palette, which I have filmed with, played with, showed. I don't know if the video is up yet, but this is what she looks like. So yeah, I think it's up. Is it up? Yeah, it's up. I have videos on all of these palettes. Then the avocado palette, which is it's so pretty. If you love greens, yes, 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 yes. At least I really love the formula in this palette. I know not everyone does, but I do. And then here I have the popcorn palette, which is also really, really pretty. It does not really scream popcorn to me. One of you even said there should have been a black in here and then be called burnt popcorn. And I thought that was brilliant. So yeah. But this is what I'm going to use today. Let me get some makeup wipes ready. I have done nothing to my face except skincare and sunscreen. Let me clean my hand. What I'm going to do is I'm going to get my random number generator. And I'm going to draw one shade from each palette. And I'm going to plop those on my eyeball. So yeah, I'm going to start in order that I showed you. So I'm going to start with the red velvet, then the peanut butter cup, slime, avocado and popcorn. So let me get them all open. How many shades do I have? 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18. Okay. So I have 18 shades. Let me also get pen and paper. I'm all over the place, as usual. And later today, because today is the 26th, I'm going to, today is the 26th of October, and in our neighborhood there is a Halloween thingy going on, which usually I was a part of, but this year I decided not to be. However, one of my friends asked if I could do her makeup, her special effects makeup, and if this goes live, I know if I have succeeded or not, but as of yet, I don't know if I will succeed. Probably, but you never know. Okay, let me see. Where is it? My random. The random.org also has an app, or at least for iPhone, so I have the app. Just so you know, I have a random.org app. I'm 1 to 18. Let's generate the shade for the, what is it called? The red velvet. Number 7. And shade number 7, let me count it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, is called brown sugar. Let me hold it like this. And that's this shade. So let me swatch it. Oh, it's very pretty. So this is the first shade. Pretty. Very, very pretty. Let me write it down. The next one is from the, what is it? Peanut Butter Cup. What? Really? And it's number 8. This video is haunted, I tell you.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Okay. So, the video is haunted. Number 8 is called Coco. And it's here, or cacao. I don't know. It's a brown. But it is a brown. Is it a shimmer though? Not really. It's kind of a brown with some glistening flecks. We're off to a really, really good start. Stop laughing. So, for the slime palette, it's going to be number 12.
Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12.
Okay, it's the color called Sludge, which is the black. It's not an ugly color story. It's just so not me. I told you this video is haunted. Maybe I should wait. Let me get some incense going. Maybe that will help to appease the spirits, the gods of the palette bingo. Maybe that'll help. Let's go to the avocado palette. There are a few browns in here. Just 3. We shall see. For the avocado palette, number 10, okay?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, wait, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, phew!
For the avocado palette, color number 10 is green gold. The colors in here. Oh, it's such, and I actually really like black and then that kind of neon-y green, you know, it's such a pretty color combination. So okay, for the last palette, the popcorn one, I need to open it, yes. Let's get the last shade for the popcorn one, which is number 3, which is called Thriller, and it is a purpley. So yeah, I think it's even a duochrome shade. Now, I know that these don't swatch the best, just so you are aware. But here is the color story. And I think I'm going to go with black smoky eye. And then with the green and the purple on the lid. And then the lower lash line will be gold with a little bit of that. Maybe I will use this in the crease to help everything, you know, get started a little bit. But that is basically the plan. So yeah, let me clean up a tiny bit. Let me put on my spider. Like a good booty guru, like that. Oh yeah, and this is a shaving accident, just so you know. It's not the first and will certainly not be the last. Oh, incense is lovely. Okay, let me prime the eyes. Let me also get some brushes. Oh, and I think I did not say, this is the Smashbox Lid Primer in Light. So I'm going to go into the color Coco from the Peanut Butter Cup, which was this brown. And I'm going to use this as a transition color to kind of help with a little bit of the brown. Black, whatever. And I want a light layer of this before I go in with the black. I do think though that if you are starting with makeup or starting with color, you know, these palettes and the reloaded ones are a very good way to start, especially if you don't have a lot of money, just because there is pigmentation there, but it is not directly in your face. Does that make any sense? And I remember when I started working with colorful eyeshadows, the people that I watched worked with color longer than me. They were used to very pigmented shadows, and that is also what they wanted. And I thought I needed to only like and work with very pigmented eyeshadows. And that went okay until I got the Hasina 2. That one was a struggle because it's not a beginner palette, or at least for me it wasn't. I was not only a beginner with color, I was a beginner with makeup altogether. So yeah, there was that. Okay, so the brown is down. I'm going to go... Do I want it underneath my eyes? Yes, let me put it underneath my eyes as well. No, I cannot. Yeah, I can. It's probably not handy because I kind of need to do my concealer as well. But this is just, I don't know, a habit. I'm going to go to the slime palette for the black called Sludge. This is a fluffier brush. And let's just kind of start building it up. And now I'm kind of going to blend it upwards into the black a bit. I actually quite like how they blend into each other. So I'm just keep on building up the black until I'm happy, basically. I actually like how this is looking, so I'm going to do the other eye. The Thriller, all my brush. I'm going to start by patting it over that black base. That's pretty. I'm also going to bring it in a bit. And I hope you can see what it does with the black base underneath. So here it's just my skin color underneath, and then here where it is darker, it has that black base underneath. And that really, it's always so pretty with the duochrome shades. Okay, now I need to go back to the black, but I need a small brush. Just going to make sure it's nice and blended here. Yes, okay, small flat brush into the green from the avocado palette, which was called Green Gold, which was this one. And I'm stretching my eye. I can kind of see where I put the glitter glue. I'm basically using this as kind of a faux cut creasy effect. I'm going to pull it on top of the purple. So one side of the brush is going into the color Green Gold, the other side in the color Thriller. So I have green on one side and purple on the other. I actually want that green a little bit further in. So I'm grabbing that color Green Gold. I'm going to spray. I'm going to stretch my eye and look down really, really well. I hope I... I want to connect it a little bit further in, out in, whatever. It's not the easiest way to do this, I'm sure. But I do like that. I'm going to place it a little bit more in my inner corner. Or at least here I'm bringing it a little bit higher. I hope that makes sense. Well, probably, because you see what I'm doing. So now I have this, and I really like it. So I'm going to do it on that eye too. Going to do my base, then I will be back and we can finish off the eye look with the lower lash line, mascara, eyeliner, falsies, pencil, all that goodness. So yeah, let me go do that real quick, or maybe not so quick, I don't know just yet, but I'll be right back, I hope. So base makeup is on and I changed the earrings, and now that I kind of know, well, what earrings I want to wear. Doesn't matter. I am going to finish off the lower lash line. Let me think. I want to kind of blend it a little bit together. Yeah, I'm going to start with the color Cocoa, which was the brown, to kind of build it up a bit. Now I want the black, but I need a tiny brush. So I'm going to go into the slime palette for the color Sludge. Okay, then I'm getting a brush. Let's get this one, doesn't matter. I'm going to smudge it a bit. Those are really Halloween-y colors. I really like this. So the incense did work. I have one color left, which was a brown sugar from the Red Velvet palette. And it is a bit... It kind of has an orangey vibe going. So maybe I should use an orangey eye pencil as well. I actually wanted to do a green, but I think maybe an orange will be fun. So I have here ColourPop's... I don't know. It's an orange one. The funny thing is that when I drew the color story, I was like, at least the first few shades. But I really, really like how it is turning out. So that is good. Let me get a pencil brush. I'm going to go into the color brown sugar. I'm going to spray it and I'm going to put it on my lower lash line. But to help the orangey bit, I'm actually going to draw a little bit of... Or I'm going to cheat, as I always do. I'm going to put the pencil a little bit lower. So that it has a bit of an orange base, you know, to stick to. And hopefully it will kind of help with the oranginess in the color brown sugar. Where's my spray here? Oh, by the way, the spray I'm using is just water. And I really want to pack it on. Oh, this is so sexy. It's pretty. Again, I'm because my brush is a bit wet now, I'm using the tip and then on the edges of the shadow, not in the middle, but on the edges, that if I do get hard pan, because my brush is still a bit wet, I don't ruin the shadow. Does that make sense? Oh, I really like how this is turning out, guys. So now I'm drying my brush on my towel, loading it up again with the color, and I'm going to do the same thing on my other eye. I brought it up a little bit higher, but I am going to go back into the avocado palette for that greeny shade. I'm going to pull that a little bit around, and now I'm kind of creating a goldeny. I like that, guys. I like that a lot, actually. For inner corner highlight, let's see if I have... I think I have a greeny highlighter. Yes, so I have here my BH Duo Light highlighter palette. I'm going to grab the color Double Take, which is this one, which is greeny-ish. Yeah, green. Am I going to spray it? I don't know. Let's see. Oh, it's so pretty. Oh, I love this palette so much. I'm actually... I don't know if you can see what I'm doing. Bring this shade a little bit... underneath there. Yeah, I like that. And because we are kind of having a Halloween-y moment today anyway, I'm going to use it as a brow bone highlight as well. I don't usually use brow bone highlights, but I thought it would be fun for today. Do I like that? I kind of do. Again, I don't usually do this, but it does not really matter, does it? So yeah. Let me kind of move everything to the side a little bit. Let's finish off the eyes with liner mascara. So let me do that. Let's also tight line. I'm really into the tight lining lately. So I just have here a black pencil that I need to sharpen again. The plan is for my eyeliner to go really close to the lashes. So let's see if I can achieve that. Let me start with this eye, because this eye usually plays nice. This eye though, let's see. Wow. I think the incense was a good idea. Okay, I like this. I'm going to wear falsies. Yes, I'm going to wear my natural ones, if I can find them. Here they are. So... Oh no, they're downstairs, really? That is so sad. Let me put on a little bit of mascara first. So I can show you the look just before the falsies. Then I will go downstairs, get my falsies and put them on. So here I have the... What is it? Catrice Glam & Doll False Lashes Mascara in Waterproof. And I think I can use it today. So yeah, let's put this on. It's a nice mascara though. I don't know if I want mascara on my bottom lashes just yet, so I'm going to leave it. But here is the look so far with mascara on the top. I like this so much. It's very pretty on its own, don't get me wrong. And I never need falsies, but I want to wear falsies, I do. But this is very pretty too. So yeah, I'm going to grab my falsies downstairs. Gonna choose a lippy and then I'm going to put my falsies on. Be back and I will show you the finished look. And if you are curious to see how I do my falsies, I do have a tutorial linked down in my description box on how I put my falsies on. And I think it's actually a very easy way to put on falsies. So yeah, I'll be right back. So everything is on and here is the finished look. I like it a lot. It was a bit of a struggle to find the lipstick that I wanted to use, but I ended up picking the one from Carity. It's one of the mattes in the color whatever. It is a brown with a little bit of a purple in it. And yeah, I actually think it complements the look very, very nicely. So yeah, I also put on a sweater because this is basically how I'm going to be the rest of the day, minus the spider, because she will probably be blown off outside because it is so windy. So yeah, I had a lot of fun with all the palettes and I think that the look that I created is so pretty. I really love this look. I think it is nice and Halloween-y and yeah, I feel really, really pretty in it. Makeup that I have on my face will be listed down in my description box. So yeah, that was it. That was it for my sweet and tasty avocado chocolate popcorn bingo look palette-ish thingy. I don't know. Just yet what I will do with that. I will name it something like that. But anyway, this is it. This is the ending. I'm going to sign off. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening, and I will see you soon in my next one. Bye guys. Ha 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 ha!